This video is going to show you how to use the Segments feature in the MailChimp widgets. The Segments feature will give you a much better idea of where people are signing up on your website. So the first thing that we need to do is need to go into your signup form, then go to General Forms, then scroll down, then over here where it says Add a Field, click Text. Now the field label can be set to whatever you want, but for the sake of readability, it would probably be best to set the field label to source. Then the field tag, this part is very important. This needs to be the word source in all caps. So S-O-U-R-C-E. So make sure it's in all caps. Then the next important part is the field visibility. Make sure that you set it to hidden. Now, the help text, this won't matter, and the default merge tag also will not matter. Now, just click Save Field. And that is all that you need to do inside MailChimp. So now I'm going to go back over into Muse and show you what the segment section needs to look like inside the widget. So when you open up the widget, if you go to Plugins, you'll see the segment section down here. So to use a segment, you just toggle it on. Once it's toggled on, it will enable this section that says Segment Options. Now you have three options for the segment options. You have Use Custom Name, Use Page URL, or Use Page Title. Now you set the page title and the page URL inside the page properties. So if you open up the page properties, the page title will automatically be whatever the page name is. It's probably going to be the best option for you because it's going to give you a very clear idea of what page the user signed up on. And if you want to be able to change the page title without changing the page name, then just toggle this off and you can set the title to be whatever you want it to be. Then another one of the segment options available is the URL. This works similarly to the page title. It is just going to display the signup source in a URL format. So instead of seeing Mr. Nice Guy with capital letters and spaces, you're going to see all lowercase and dashes instead of spaces. For this example, I made three different pages that will demonstrate each segment option. So in this first one, I have it set to use the page title. Then on the second one, I have it set to use the page URL. And on the third, I have it set to use a custom segment name that I entered in right here. So I'm not going to publish these. And I already have them open inside my browser, so I'm just going to refresh the page real quick. So for Mr. Nice Guy, this one was set to use the page title. So as you can see the page title up here. So when I sign up and confirm the email, the segment source should be Mr. Nice Guy. So it's just going to tell me that I need to confirm the email, so I'll do that in just a second. I'm going to go over to Mr. Shiny and enter in a different email. It's telling me the same thing. There's the email. And there's the other email. And if you remember, let's see, Mr. Shiny was set to the page URL. So this is what should show up inside MailChimp for Mr. Shiny. Then Mr. Awesome. Let's just use my normal email. Oops. Now Mr. Awesome should show that the signup source is Mr. Awesome's landing page. So before I confirm the email, I'll just show you the demo form. It has zero subscribers in it. And I will come back as soon as I confirm the emails so you can see what happened. Okay, so I went in and I confirmed the email, and as you can see, the source now says for jp.26 at Outlook, says the signup source is Mr. Nice Guy because he was using the page title. Then for this one, it's showing the page URL because it was using the page URL segment option. And this last one is showing Mr. Awesome's landing page, and because I use the custom segment option. So that's how the segment option works.